Hello guys and welcome to another episode. Today we are going to talk about this Ferrari California model that is made from Hot Wheels. A few things first. In this particular model, I paint this part here with a marker, the black color, because before you could see the color of the interior and it wasn't very nice. Also, I paint the front grille black because I like it better this way. Before it was all silver color, and I also added with a marker a little bit of chrome effect in the exhausts. You cannot see it very clearly. You see it like it's a plain silver, like it used to be when I bought this model, but if you could see, like here in the shadow, you can see the reflection of the chrome that I added with the marker in the exhaust pipes. So this is the things that I've done to the model. Otherwise, the rest is stock. So, being said that, we can start showcasing this car. This model car has some plastic parts. And overall, it has a good representation of the actual model car. For example, the wheels are very nicely made. The seats are very detailed. It has the roof that you can remove and put back anytime you want. It's very easy. It has some very good elements, like the size of the model car. It's a true scale. The size, it's not smaller than it should be, like for example the Maisto or Burago California Tough, which is a little bit smaller than it should be. A tiny difference, but it is a difference. So this is true to scale size. The hood is plastic and it doesn't feel very durable. Haven't braked it yet, but it doesn't feel very durable. The engine has low level of details, basically almost none. So if you want to have a detailed engine, this is definitely not the model that you would like to choose. The headlights have also a level of detail. Looks good, looks realistic, but they are not so detailed. But again, for the price point of the model, you can expect much. So here you can see that the front wheels turn left and right, it also roll, but you don't have suspensions. The doors are open nicely, the hinges are very good. This is the way that you remove the roof. It has the black piece of plastic here, like the real car, and also there is the black lining. It's plastic, but it's the black lining that the roof would have in the real car. And it goes back on very easily with the hinges. You remove it. Stable enough, not very stable, but stable enough. The mirrors on the doors are very reflective, very nicely made. The rear view mirror has this vinyl mirror decal that it's blurry. It's not like the side mirrors that are very nice and clear. You can see all the details. The interior has not many details. You can see that the screen is just a black screen. No buttons painted. The tachometer is clear enough. The logo in the steering wheel is clear enough. Of course, if you are good in painting, You can paint the buttons yourself and make it look more detailed. But straight from factory, you can see that there are not a lot of things made in the interior. In general, the interior is accurate. The seats are exactly like the real car, very nicely made. The only bad thing is that as a low-cost model, the doors sometimes tend not to close entirely. As you can see here, there's a play to it. So yeah, if I leave it, the door stays on. The taillights are also accurate enough. Here the color of the vehicle is red, so you cannot see a lot. But if it was in different color, you could see the level of details in the tail lights. The trunk also is very spacious. I like also the fact that it's flat and it doesn't have like an obstacle here, so you can slide stuff inside. This is a wheel, by the way, from Lamborghini Aventador, the rear wheel, which is big. And you can see that you can fit easily this wheel inside the trunk. And also, you can put other stuff inside here too. You can see that it has a lot of space around the wheel, and it closes with no problem at all. The trunk opens and closes very nicely. It has very small hinges in the sides, also plastic, I think, from the feel. Closes very good. The only thing that it's not very good, and you can say that it's a reason not buying this model, is that you can see the red plastic inside from the glass. This is not very nice. You can always paint it yourself black by removing the windshield, but it's not a very easy task. Maybe you can break also something by trying to do this, so it's not something that many people would do. This is something that I don't like. It bothers me more than the door that not closes entirely. But yes, overall, it's a good model to have it in your collection. It's a toy grade, in my opinion. But again, for the price point, it's a very well made and executed car. For me, it was something that I wanted to buy because I wanted to have this model car side by side with California TAF that I have from Maisto. And that is the reason that I bought it. Otherwise, to be honest, I wouldn't buy it. The main reason is that it's bigger. It's true scale, so it is bigger than most of the cars that I have. If I put it side by side with the GT Spirit, it looks okay. But if I put it side by side with the Maisto Ferrari or other Maisto models or Burago models or Welly models or whatever, this model car looks slightly bigger, so it is something that you should have in mind. But anyway, it is a very nice model car and I don't regret buying it. So that is all for today's video. I hope you liked it and you find the information useful. Please write me in the comments if you have any questions or you want to add something. I also appreciate any negative or positive feedback from you. So yeah, that is all for today. Stay safe, take care, and see you. Bye bye.